We worship you. Agbani lagbato. Your covenant remains the same. Let your feelings flow.
Can you quickly pray these three prayer points? Father, you are the lifter of head. In tonight's service, lift up my head. Are you listening to me? It does not cost him anything. What you say you would do, that is what you will do. That is why you are called Jehovah. He only need to decide to do it. Listen, I am here tonight to introduce to you the God that breaks protocols. Are you listening to me? His name is the lifter of heads. It will damn any consequences. It will damn everything. And it will come to you and just lift you. Whether you follow principle or not, when the Lord comes, it does not really matter. He's the one that decides. The Bible says that I will show mercy unto whom. That means there is no criteria. But I just decided to choose. I just decided to show you mercy. I know your sins. I know your iniquity. I know what you've done. You can't hide it from me. But tonight I just choose to show you mercy. Say, oh Lord, the lifter of head, lift up my head in tonight's service. Open your mouth, begin to pray. Open up your mouth, begin to pray. Oh, I call upon your name. Let your grace and your mercy call upon me, Lord. Oh, Lua, Mowasi Bite, Jeki Ore Ofe Ati Anure, Jekoro Lemi Lori, Baba. Of work in my academics, I have repeated class several times. Father, lift up my head. Father, lift up my head. You said to the children of Israel, you've stayed too long far on this mountain, and Lord, you lift them high. I know you are able. I know you have the power, you have the might, you have the ability. Father, I submit tonight, oh God. Father, I will not live here until you lift up my head. Father, lift up my head. Maritally, spiritually, ministerially, academically, business-wise, career-wise, Father, lift up my head. Jehovah Jireh. We worship you, Lord. Meo, Emi Oriru Olorun Eiri. Lord, in tonight's service, Lord, in tonight's service, you are, I acknowledge you as the lifter of head. Lift me. Let the world seize your hand in my life. Let people know that you are able to lift. Because you can lift. Father, lift up my head. Father, lift up my head. Lift up the head of my wife. Lift up the head of my husband. Lift up the head of my children. In their academics, oh God, let them be outstanding. Father, lift up my head. In Jesus mighty name we pray. The second prayer point. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 45. Can we have Isaiah 45 verse 3? Isaiah 45 verse 3. The Bible says he opened a door and no one can what? Hallelujah. He said, I will give thee the treasures of darkness, the hidden riches of secret places. He said, thou thou might know that I, the Lord, which called thee by thy name, I am the God of Israel. Go to verse 2. I will go before thee and make the crooked way straight. I will break in pieces the gate of brass and put asunder the bar of what? Of iron. Verse 4. Now, for Jacob my servant's sake and Israel my elect, I have called thee by thy name. I have what? Surnamed thee. Thou hast known not me. No, sorry. Thou art what? Hast not known me. Continue. He said, I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I glad thee, thou, though thou hast not known me. Continue. And he went further. He said, that they may know from the rising of the sun to draw, and from the west, that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none. Verse 7. He said, I form the light, I create darkness, I make peace, I create evil. I am the Lord. I the Lord, do all these things. Continue. He said, drop down, ye heaven, far above, and let the sky pour down righteousness. Let the heart open. Let the what? Let the heart open. And let them bring forth salvation. And let righteousness bring forth together. I, the Lord, have created it. Say, Father, open doors that no witches, that no power, that no forces of darkness can close. Father, open them for me. Can you open your mouth and pray? Can you open your mouth and pray? In my place of work, in my place of business, in ministry, Father, open the doors. Father, open the doors. Command from heaven. The Bible says, be lifted, O ye gates, and be thou lifted, O ye ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. He said, who is the King of glory? He said, the Lord strong and mighty. He said, the Lord mighty in battle. Father, open the doors, that no sin, no power for my father's house, no witchcraft manipulation, no marine spirit can close. Father, open them in tonight's service. In tonight's service, Father, open the doors for me. Open the floodgates in abundance and cause your rain, Lord, to fall on us. Open the floodgates in abundance and cause your rain, Lord, to fall on us. Father, open doors into my service. I didn't come to be a spectator. I didn't come, oh Lord, to look at beautiful people. I didn't come, oh God, to just be one of the numbers. Father, open doors for me tonight, oh God, in my place of work. Let me return back to work tomorrow. And Lord, experience open doors. Let me experience open doors, oh God. Kaya bakasata, la bakada baye bokojena, le kada bakada bakada, le grada kasata ya kadia, masike ye bokoshata, le bakada baba. Over my finances, over my career, over my ministry, over my marriage. Kaya baba baba ye kada, le baba 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 ye kede kede. Lord, open, Daddy, open, Daddy, open, Daddy, open. Kaya bakata kada, lebra kada ba yebo kushida, masikada ba. Lord, open the doors for me in tonight's service. I am ready, O Goreo. I am ready, O Goreo. I am ready, O Gore. Oh, you are. open the doors. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The last prayer point. He enthroned David. He enthroned Esther. Father, you enthroned David. Father, you enthroned Esther. Lord, tonight enthrone me. Enthrone me in glory. Enthrone me in favor. Enthrone me in honor. Enthrone me, oh God. Father, tonight, in tonight's service, can we turn it to prayer? Can we turn it to prayer? Father, you enthrone David. Father, you enthrone Esther in tonight's service by your mighty hand, oh God. Lord, enthrone me. He's able, abundantly able to deliver. Lord, in tonight's service, Father, enthrone me. Father, enthrone me. Father, enthrone me by your mercy. You said, by not by power, not by might, but by my spirit. Nishilo Nimotiwa Emi Oloro lo shamono miwa Nirama Lemitiwa Emi Oloro lo shamono mibo Emi Oloro Bogo bade ko be mi fo Emi Olorun Bogo bade ko be mi fo Emi lo pade emi Olore Alore bade alore ni shilo Emi lo pade emi Olore Alore pade alore ni shilo Iwo lo ni wa Baba mo ti de o Aye mi towo re ba mi tuse Sebi iwo la mo koko Aye mi o Oluwa mami bo se fe Bi o ba mami mari bo se fe Bi o ba mami aye mi o duwo Se bi wo la mo koko aye mi o Oluwa mami bo se fe Yeshua reference you, mighty God. There is none like you in all the earth. We thank you, O Lord, because you are the lifter of our heads. The Bible says you take us from the miry clay. You set us above the hills. Father, now we know that you are God and you are never a man. We come before you tonight that every soul here and those that are watching us online, that we lift up their head far above their present situation. That those that the powers and the forces of their father's house have buried their head in sorrow, in pain, in affliction, in humiliation, oh God, that tonight your hand will come from above and you will lift them high. You will lift them high. You will lift them high. If they should tell Esther that she will become a queen, she would never believe it. But your mercies located her and you enthroned her. Oh Lord, you remove fasting and you put Esther. Tonight, oh God, let your mercy locate each and every one and enthrone them in favor, enthrone them in wealth, enthrone them in establishment, enthrone them in grace, enthrone them in favor, enthrone them in their next level. Father, enthrone them in royalty. Thank you, Father. If there is anyone here tonight that something is not right in their anatomy, Father, I hand them over to you. Whatever that is, that pain or sickness, Lord, I table them before you in the theater room of heaven. The great surgeon, walk on them now. Whatever organ that needs to be replaced, whatever system that needs to be replaced, whatever it that is in their body that is not functioning very well, whether their heart, their mind, their soul, their spirit, their lungs, their kidney, their liver, their small intestine, large intestine, their reproductive organs, their womb, any part of their body that needs a replacement, Father, tonight, replace it. Father, tonight, replace it. Lord Jesus, replace it. Lord Jesus, replace it. That everyone will leave this auditorium and will end this service online testifying that you are good. Everybody testify you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Everybody testify you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. You are good.
Everybody
testify you are. You are so good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Everybody testify you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Hallelujah, nasiye bube. Everybody testify you are so good.
You are good.
Everybody testify you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Hallelujah. Alpha, Omega. Alpha, Omega. You are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today. Alpha, Omega. Alpha, Omega. Alpha, Omega. You are worthy of my praises.
Jesus,
hallelujah. I don't just know, my spirit just keeps singing.
Oh, Timo, me, but baby, we're
on
Ibanu, like a dog.
Taking Paulo, Nito,
pursuit you.
Oh, hey.
Oh, Timo, me, but baby, Ibanu, take a dog.
Tori, we pray.
I share a right, we show you why.
He has given me victory.
I will lift him higher.
I am Jehovah.
I will lift him higher.
He has given me victory.
I will lift him higher.
I am Jehovah.
I will lift him higher.
That is your name.
Sing it higher.
Hallelujah, let's be seated. Hallelujah. O sheto doju adura ti mi. O sheto
doju adura ti mi.
O sheto doju adura ti mi.
O sheto doju adura ti mi.
Iwo lo bi ki
mama dawe.
Iwo lo bi
ki mama wando. O sheto doju adura ti mi.
Abata, the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Father, help me. John chapter 15, verse 8. Even the message is not coming. Oh. Oh, no, me, Jamie, no.
Bata, bata, oh. Oh, no, me, Jamie, no. Bata, bata.
Oh, no, me, Jamie, no. Bata, bata,
oh. Oh, si, no, me, Jamie, no. Bata, bata.
Alagara, man, oloro, mi.
Alagara, agara, ipo,
life of somebody tonight. Hallelujah. Honestly, it's just because I don't know how to sing South African songs, but there is something in the house that is different tonight. The there is something in the house. I know the lifter of head is here already. And I know this is just the season. Somebody's head, somebody's life, somebody's destiny is craving to be lifted. Somebody's life is yearning. Somebody is saying enough is enough. Somebody's spirit is saying, oh Lord, I am tired. I want to go higher. I want to go to the next level. Hear this tonight in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Yahweh, I command your head to be lifted. 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 Somebody say, oh Lord, how long? Oh Lord, how long? How long? How long? I see other people beside me rising. I see people, their life changing. Lord, how long? But the Lord said, I should tell you tonight, not long, but now. I said now, 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 now. The Lord is lifting you. Sir, not long. You are there. The Lord said you are there. Just a little, 1, 2, 3 step. You are there. The big door is open unto you. And listen, you are entering not just into your season of rest, you are entering into your season of prosperity. The people will see you and say, how does it happen? What did you do? The Lord said, I should tell you, he has come. Hallelujah. I am saying to somebody tonight, your testimony will be loud. That amen is not born again. That amen is not born again. I said, your testimony will be loud. Your testimony will be loud. Your testimony will be loud. In the name of Jesus. There is a way God changed the story of a man that even the man himself does not understand. We are talking about, oh God, the lifter of head. The Bible says, he lifted the poor out of the miry clay. A clay is not a place where you can stand. You will sleep. But the Bible says, from that point, the Lord took over. I don't know the point where you are now. I don't know the point where you are. But tonight, if you can just submit, if you can just surrender and let the Lord take over, somebody scream it at the top of your voice. Say, oh Lord, take over. Say, oh Lord, take over. Say, oh Lord, take over. Not my power, not my ability. Lord, I am tired of thinking. How will it happen? How will it come? Where will it come from? When will it happen? Oh Lord, the lifter of head. There is a way God lifts a man, and there is nothing that can bring him down. Tonight I see your head being lifted. I see your position being changed. I see blessings locating you. I see transformation upon your life. I see your friend asking questions. Oh Lord, the lifter of my head. The lifter of my head. You can't think God, even imagine. He is God. David was seated, minding his own business. We never read that David prayed. We never read that David fasted. He was somewhere minding his business, and they sent a messenger. Hear this in the Holy Ghost. Before the end of this week, a message of your lifting shall come. 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 Esther was just seated at home, just seated, minding her business. Oh Lord, oh matter. The Bible says he lifted some, he brings some down, but among the ones that he will lift, you are one of them. I said 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 you are one of them. Stop thinking how it will happen. How will it happen? Where? When? Mama, can I talk to you? Hallelujah. Tell your husband to calm down. There is a breakthrough coming. A mighty breakthrough that will change his status in this same Pretoria North. Hallelujah. See, passing through the king, but there is one ingredient that God added to Esther, and that ingredient was favor. You will scream it at the top of your voice. You will shout it at the top of your voice. Shout, oh Lord, the lifter of head, add to my life tonight in this service. Therefore, open your mouth, begin to pray. Favor, 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 favor. In the morning, in the noontime, in the evening, at midnight, Father, favor. Add to my life, add to my ministry, Father, favor. Father, favor. Favor my ways. Favor my ministry. Favor me, O Lord. Favor me, O Lord. Kaya basu tali kadia. Libro koso toye kede kaya mokosheda. Father, I lean on you. Favor me tonight. Favor me tonight. Favor my wife. Favor my children. Favor my business. Favor my career. Father, favor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please be seated. Be seated. Let's read John chapter 8. Please quickly. Chapter 15, verse 8. John 15, verse 8. John 15, verse 8. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's important. This service must not close without reading this. John chapter 15, verse 8. He said, by this my Father is glorified. By what? By this. This, which this? By your lifting. By your lifting. He said, by this my Father is glorified, that you what? Bear much fruit. That you bear what? I curse poverty in your lineage. He said that you bear much fruit. That you bear. So that ye be what? My disciple. That ye bear much fruit. And that your fruit remaineth. Another verse of the scripture say that. That you bear fruit. And your fruit remaineth. See, God is glorified when you prosper. God is glorified when you are lifted. God is glorified when things are working. That is why I love that song. It's just unfortunate I can't sing it very well. All things are working for my good. He's intentional. Ever failing.
All things are working for my good.
All things. God moves all things to work for your good.
Never failing.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know that there were people during the time on Sunday? Some of you were not invited. Sorry for that. It was not a big wedding like that. It was just meant to be something very small. You know, that between Mosutu and Dekin Paul, it was not meant to be something big. You know, it was just meant to be something small. Now, listen to this. Right there at the ceremony, come and look at comment. I was standing with my friend and Pastor Martins. Listen, I'm a spiritual man. Even if you don't speak out, I can sense what is in your heart by the Spirit of God. Some people are saying, don't mind them. Very soon they will break up. Let us come and witness it so that we can witness their breakup. Look at how devilish people can be. Let us witness this so that we can witness their breakup too. And some people are saying that, it's just a scam. All these are shambles. It's just a scam. If there is something that young man wants from that lady, is bribing her with a car. Do you know that when some people's life have been destroyed, when they see other people's life being lifted, there is something that happens to them. It's like a magic. It's like a film trick. It's like a film trick. Listen to this. Understand this in the journey of life. Not everybody wants your lifting. Some call themselves your friend. In fact, do you know that at times we invite our enemies to come and witness our rising? And when they get there, they thought the food will not be enough. Oro boti ton. Oro boti bari. Ono tolu wa gbegba. O tu wa je omo ila. Ewo. E tu wo. Ewo. E tu wo.
All out, all out,
Hallelujah.
When they
discovered that, do you know that there was a time this family was struggling? They couldn't pay house rent. They sold their car and they were walking on the street. They were taking Taxify and people said it was over. Listen to this. My enemies. Am I talking to somebody tonight? My enemies. Don't celebrate yet. Don't rejoice yet. Don't celebrate yet. Don't be happy yet. Don't be in joyful mood yet. Don't pour champagne yet. When I fall, I am a Santa Cadia. Don't mind those that are mocking you now. Don't mind those that are laughing at you. Recover. They are still thinking. Do you know that every night some people look at the pictures? Some people are asking for forgiveness. Some people are saying, no. And some people are looking at it every day and they are crying. Hear this in the Holy Ghost. Those that want your downfall, they will cry into the grave. I said they will cry into the grave. 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 Goliath, they look at him. Some people have said, besotted, now that day is over, night is drawing shadows of the evening fill out from the sky. They started seeking for David. They believe that how will this young man survive? Goliath, David, they've relegated him. So, in fact, some people have read it. They've sent money for the casket. That, okay, I know, okay, it's my brother. is from here to here. Okay, coffee maker, make the coffee, prepare the coffee, because we know. And as David was going, the brother was saying, David, bye bye. Listen, but they were looking, they stood from afar, they were waiting for his fall. Everyone that is standing aloof, waiting for your fall, waiting for your demise, waiting for your destruction, waiting for your bankruptcy, hear this in the Holy Ghost, they shall be put to shame. 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 They were watching. Very soon they will bury. I'm so sure some people have already dug the grave. And they were waiting. But when Goliath fell, look at how people can change within a twinkle of an eye. There is a miracle they call miracle ojiji. Sudden miracle. Sudden change. Sudden transformation. Sudden breakthrough. Sudden prosperity. That shall be your portion tonight. That shall be your portion tonight. In this breakthrough service, you will break forth. In business, you will break forth. Maritally, you will break forth. Financially, you will break forth. Career-wise, you will break forth. In that transaction, you will break forth. In ministry, you will break forth. They were just looking. Oh, how a story can change within the twinkle of an eye. Don't give up. Don't give in. Don't give up. No matter the storms, no matter the wind, listen to this. No matter how hard the wind blow, the Iroko tree will never bow. Listen to this. Let God make you an Iroko tree that cannot bow to any storm of life. Storms will come. Affliction will come, the Bible says. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome. Where are the overcomers tonight? 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 Man of God, can I see you on Friday? I said, no, you can't see me on Friday. What is going on? He said, I'm going again to go and pay Lobola. And the man of God said, what is going on here? Are you paying Lobola every month? I said, every week. I said, yes. This is our season of fruitfulness. Am I talking to somebody? This is our season of enthronement. Hallelujah. How will people know that God is faithful? By where? Until we bear fruit. I'm paying Lobola this weekend. I'm doing wedding next weekend. Throughout the month of October, not one day, not one weekend, not one weekend. Hear this. To some of you that still believe that you will pay your Lobola before the end of this year, I tap into the graces that have worked for the people that have paid their home before the end of 2020. My God, the lifter of hell, is lifting you up financially. It's lifting you up financially. It's lifting you up financially. It's lifting you up financially. When Pastor Martins reminded me of the couples that are getting married on the 25th. I said, Jesus Christ, all the weekends in the month of October. And I had the Lord saying to me, for the next 3 Sundays, do the impartation of houses. The impartation of what? God will never speak and not bring it to pass. I don't care whether you have 2 or 3. You can have estate and become an estate agent. Hallelujah. Oh no, I'm serious. Free of charge. One of my daughters, I told her in the church, I said, somebody is going to give you a car. She said, amen. 2 days ago. No, I said 2 days ago. Yesterday, she sent the picture of the car and she started praying for me. She has never driven a car before in her life. And they brought her in a new car. And she was praying for me. I said, Jesus Christ, pray more, more, more. Pray more, 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 more. She was happy. Happy. She didn't buy it. They gave it to her. Now hear this. If God is God in my life, if God is God in this church, in the name that is above every other name, before the end of this year, Mary will give you gifts. 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 I said they will give you gifts. Do you know there is somebody here? Your husband is about to replace your car with another car. Hallelujah. So you just kept quiet. I said, how will it happen? But you come and give me the testimony. Because God is going to surprise people here. Say to yourself, God is going to surprise me. The people that mock David were the first to run and carry him. Hear this in the name of the Lord. The people that mocked you will be the first to celebrate with you. In the name of Jesus. 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 I have learned one thing in life. Never to dishonor anybody. I've learned it in my life. Never to disregard anybody. Because, listen, when God said, I have come, he will not jump from heaven and stand. He will use men. And you know one thing about God? He can use that person you don't like. That's, I don't hate people. I will never hate anybody. I will never disregard anybody, no matter who you are. After all, Mary Magdalene was a prostitute. She was one of the first set of people that saw Jesus. So, you see, he's a merciful father. Listen, as you return back home tonight, an overcomer, leave everything to God. And don't wake up in the night and start crying again. How will it happen? It's not for overcomers. How will it happen? It's not for overcomers. I'm a man of a strong faith. Those that follow me, they look at me and they say, let us be reasonable. I say, no. When it comes to faith, reason does not work. I like your input. I like your contribution. But listen, don't dampen my faith. I know my God of by this time tomorrow. My God of by this time tomorrow, a man can sleep hungry, no food, but wake up in the morning, a mega millionaire. That is the God that I serve. Hear this, beloved of God. No matter what, listen, keep calm. Just what? Don't cry again. Don't look at the bills that have not been paid. Don't look at the bills. Look at him that seated upon the throne of mercy. The more you look at him, the more the bills will be paid. The more you look at him, the more. See, every day comes with its own sorrow and pain. But the more you look unto Jesus, the Bible calls him the author and the finisher. That problem, he will finish it. Don't worry. Standing there at the wedding of both of them, and I remember when this family, this couple, were going through their trial time, affliction will come, the Bible says. Everything can never be rosy all the time. There will be your downtime, but in the midst of the storm, it never leaves. There are times some of us say, God has abandoned me because of my multiple sins. But yet, in the midst of the storm is there. It does not look at your errors or your mistakes. If God is marking iniquity, the Bible says nobody can stand. But the Bible says his mercies endure it forever. There are new mercies every day. Every day, there are new mercies every day. I am so sure. During the time they were going through the storm, some people will have given advice. You will now see series of advice. Family members will come and said, come and do this. Why can't you compromise and bow down to idols? Why can't you just let us bring some charms, some muti? It does not compromise your faith. Don't worry. God will not be annoyed with you. That is when people will start thinking for you. But this family continue. If you don't see anything, or you've been hearing testimonies from pastor and you've not seen it yourself, at least last Saturday, Sunday, you saw it. To some of you that were there, some of you that were not there, you saw it on my Facebook, on my profile. You saw both of them in the same encore. Listen. There is a reward for faithfulness. There is a reward for faithfulness. Some of you think men are stupid and they are fools. Listen to this. Men know who are true and who are fake. Let me tell you something. A man can have a girlfriend outside, but he knows that this woman, he knows that that girlfriend is just temporal, but this one is everlasting. She's not going anywhere. And listen, a day is coming, listen sisters, that your faithfulness shall be rewarded. When he came to me and they gave me the key to the car and said, give it to present it, I said where is the car? They point the car to me and I look at the car. I said, this woman deserves this. When I gave her the car key, I was shaking myself. I said, this is faithfulness. This is a reward for faithfulness. You know a true woman when he stand with the husband. Myself and Dickness Kelly were in the car listening to Apostle Joseph Selman one day, and he was talking about the man is the covering of the woman, and we were is the head of the woman, and he was analyzing it, and I've never saw that analogy before. He said, listen, your husband is your covering, cover him up. To some of you that love to expose your husband, you better think very well. The man might fall into a season of compromise, but he's not stupid. He knows that he's cheating on you, and you are not talking. You are not fighting. One day, God will touch him, and he will look at you and say, Babe, do you know what? From this day onward, I promise you, I thought you will fight me. I thought you will pack your load. I thought you will leave. I thought you are going to leave the children. I thought you are going to abandon us. I thought you are going to make compromise. But you choose to stay with me. Listen, from today onward till my dying day, I promise you, I will never disappoint you again. There is something your faithfulness will do to a man that will make him to know that no, you are not perfect. He is not perfect, but you stood by an imperfect man. Faithfulness. Faithfulness. Another woman will have abandoned the husband and start making compromise. Why, where are the boyfriend? After all, we have to eat. Man must work. I must look good. I must put makeup. I must put everything. People must see me good. But she will come. Even when they were not eating, she will come. She will not even complain. Nobody will even know. And she will be doing her thing. She will stand as an usher in the church. And God is looking from heaven. I said, these people are worthy. See, let me tell you something. Those of you. Look down from heaven. God is a rewarder. You are too faithful to fail. You are too faithful to rest in and support me now.
You prove yourself to be alive and important.
Just keep pushing, don't worry. The road is not easy. That woman says, sang that song. Nobody told me the road will be easy, and I
don't believe it's gonna be this far to me.
You will fall and you must stand up. Look back and okay, don't worry, keep moving. Dust yourself and keep moving. The road. road will not always be smooth. The journey of life is not always smooth. It's not. Always understand that you will find yourself in the valley. Even though you didn't desire the valley, but you find yourself in the valley. But from the valley floor, there is always a hand that lifted. The Bible said David was in the cave of Adullam, and worthless men came. I have my own problem. Other people are bringing their own problem to me. Why will I be in a problem? And problem people will even come with problem. But the same David that was sleeping in the cave, when they built the city of David, he looked to the city of David and he was just but glorifying God. If not for the Lord that have been on our side. And he wrote that scripture. If not for the, he remembered the cave experience. He remembered when they were at Ziklag, when the Amorite came and burned everything they've labored for and took their family and their prized possessions. And the Bible said he wept, he cried. God saw your secret tears. You think the man didn't cry? There are nights he will sit down and he will be crying all alone, all by himself. And the wife will say, "Oni, it's okay. Oni, it's fine. Things will be fine." And one day the wife will also sit down and be crying. And the husband will look at her and will not be able to stand at home. He said, "Okay, Godwin, can you pick me up?" Because the wife is crying. He does not know how to console the wife. There are times he will bring himself low and say, I beg. Yemi, can you just send me 50 rand? Hallelujah. Please don't let us forget Friday and on Sunday service, first service and second services, and the Lord will bless you as you do so. And please, no matter what it is, let's keep serving the Lord and let us evangelize. Let's evangelize. Let's talk to people about the church, about what God is doing here, about the mighty things, the great things that God is recommend this church to people. And you will see that your life and destiny will never be the same. Shall we rise to our feet as we go tonight? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Bring out your water if you have one. Hallelujah. Father, I speak to these waters. Father, I speak to this water. Father, I speak to this water. Whatever it is, oh God, that the enemy has planted, Father, by the reason of this water, flush it out. Amen. Flush it out. Amen. Flush it out. Amen. I speak upon the waters. Waters, be empowered. Water, receive power. Water, receive power. Water, receive power. Water, receive power. I stand as an oracle of the Lord. As you go home tonight, the Lord be with you. As you sprinkle this water upon your property, hear this in the Holy Ghost, it will not be stolen. Your house will not be burgled into. In the name of Jesus, I am saying once again, in the name that is above every other name, every power of the marine spirit, all their hopes and covenant over your life is broken tonight. It's broken tonight. It's broken tonight. In the name of Jesus, I command life into that water. I command life into your life. And I pray for the rest of this week, you shall be favored. For the rest of this week, you shall be honored. For the rest of this week, you shall be connected. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost abide with us.
God bless you, beloved of God. I hope you enjoy this powerful, wonderful service. Listen to me, beloved. Understand one thing. God has ordained you for the next level. God has ordained you for success. God has ordained you for breakthrough. I want you to join us, Church East City Chapel International, 558 Garrett Matthews Street, Pretoria North. I want you to join us every Wednesday, 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. It's a powerful prayer service, 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Your life and your destiny needs prayers. You need to pray your way to the next level. And every Saturday, 5 a.m. to 7 p.m.